Good morning. It's good to see all of you today. What a beautiful day it is compared to last Sunday. Last Sunday was a little hot, but thank God it's a little cooler today, and wonderful to see you all and good to be together as we gather for worship today. Please do take note that we have several birthdays. You'll see in the bulletin the whole month of August, there are many, many birthdays, but we have several this week between our two churches, and I want to make note of all of them. Tomorrow, Sue Creevy is having a birthday. We wish Sue a very happy birthday tomorrow. But she has to share her birthday. Cass Cassiano from Frankfurt Memorial is also having a birthday tomorrow. She's a very nice lady. It must be August 1st. Must be. John Combe is having a birthday August 2nd, but I don't see John today. John's not here. Well, we asked Farrell if you would wish John a happy birthday for us. Also on the 2nd, Kyra Lewis Gale from Frankfurt Memorial is having a birthday. August the 4th, Joan Thompson from here at Crescentville is having a birthday. Again, August 4th. August 5th, Diana Wilson is having a birthday. Diana, we wish you a very happy birthday this week. And then on August the 6th, Ross Franklin from Frankfurt Memorial is having a birthday. It's a busy week, but I'd ask if there are other birthdays that you know of folks who are having, do you know of anyone having a birthday this coming week? Yes, Elfa. Sherma is having a birthday on the 5th of August. We wish Sherma a happy birthday. Coco? Okay, your step-grandson is supposed to come into the world, and you'll tell us next week if that happened or not. Okay, all right. Diana? Your son's birthday, which son? David is having a birthday August the 4th. Her birthday is today, so a lot of Wilson birthdays this week. Well, we wish all of you a happy birthday this week. Cass? Who is that again? Samantha's also having a, is she nice? We're just making sure. Okay. Zelfa. On the 7th? And who is that again? Gigi. Gigi's having a birthday on the 7th. Well, please wish her a happy birthday for us, August 7th. Sue? According to legend, which one is it? The father? George, with George Jetson. How many of you know George Jetson? We're going to show our ages, right? All of you young people. Kelsey, George Jetson, Google him. You'll want to know about George Jetson. Thank you for that. Now, that's legend, though. Let's confirm that if we can. He is a legend, right? Any other birthdays in the coming days? Are there any other announcements to be made besides George Jetson? Oh, Sue, if you have Tuesday night, there is a bike night. We're trying to get to see who's interested in going. So if you're interested, Joshua, or any of you young people, let Sue know, and we'll work that out for Tuesday evening. We're looking forward to that night. Any other announcements this week? Then let's look around. Let's welcome each other through our chorus of welcome. I'm so glad I'm a part of the family of God. And let's stand together as we sing. Let us join together as we're called into worship this morning through these words of Psalm 107. Give thanks to the Lord because he is good. His love is eternal. Repeat these words in praise to the Lord, all you whom he has saved. He has rescued you from your enemies and has brought you back from foreign countries, from east and west, from north and south. Some wandered in the trackless desert and could not find their way to a city to live in. They were hungry and thirsty and had given up all hope. Then in their trouble, they called to the Lord, and he saved them from their distress. He led them by a straight road to a city where they could live. They must thank the Lord for his constant love, for the wonderful things he did for them. He satisfies those who are thirsty and fills hungry with good things. Let us sing thankfully, Great is thy faithfulness.
Changest not, thy compassions, they fail not. As thou hast been, thou forever wilt be. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see.
Let's pray together. O God, with whom is the way of life, and in whose presence we see eternity, lift our eyes beyond the shadow of earthly things which pass away, that we may cling to those of heaven which are eternal. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God, world without end. Amen. You may be seated. And if you happen to peek ahead, you'll see the title of the sermon today is Greed is Not Good. And as I think of our children, who hopefully will learn and are learning that greed is not good, one of the ways, hopefully, that we learn as children, and you young people can help me if you're learning this truth, is to learn about sharing. Sharing. How many of you have been learning how to share? Some of us older people, we're still learning how to share. But as young people, is that something that we still teach? Sharing is still important? Yes? Yes, says the mother of four children? Absolutely. Sharing is essential. Now, if we're an only child, we may not know how to share quite as well, and we may still need to learn that truth. But hopefully, as we're young, there are those who are wise among us who are teaching us to share. Because sharing combats greed. Sharing teaches us that there are others for which to care. And so I hope that young people, you're learning that, and I hope that you're modeling that. I have never seen selfish behavior, so I'm glad to see that. I think of many of you who were with us just a few weeks ago at Music and Drama Camp. I don't think I saw any fighting back there over snacks. Miss Wendy, did you see any? No, you wouldn't allow it. But no, thankfully, we try to learn that truth. Because as we're going to hear a little later, Jesus warns us about greed. He warns us to watch out so that we don't be greedy. And so thankfully, sharing is something that we're learning. And even if we are a little older, I appreciate those of you who are a little older who raised your hand honestly to say we're still learning. Hopefully we can learn better and share better, and our children can learn and teach us in their sharing. Amen. As we move to prayer, as we pray for our young people, as we pray for each other, I would ask if there are concerns that you would have us to pray for each other, if there are joys that you would have to share this morning. Are there joys or concerns that you would have this morning? Linda, you want the boys to go already? You want the boys to leave already? Good mother and son time together. Wonderful. Other joys or other concerns this morning? Carol, Pastor Peter and Pastor Linda. Oh, she's not pastor. Okay, chaplain. Chaplain Linda. Okay. Well, we're glad for that. Pastor Jack, as some of you may know, Pastor Jack retired from the Protestant home. He still is at Bethany Church. Serving there, but he is no longer the chaplain at the Protestant home. We wish him well in retirement, but are glad to know that there are new chaplains. I'm looking forward possibly to meeting them. I'll be there on Tuesday, so I'll be looking forward maybe to meeting them then. Well, let's pray for Allie as she is alone in New York this week, and prayers for David as he is traveling today. Yes, Zelfa, what a joy it is to see you with them. And we're glad that they're able to be. Lennon is with us today. If you didn't recognize that young man, I did not. It's been a while, but Lennon is with us. We're great. Well, it's good that they could be with you. Yes, yes. Other joys or other concerns this morning? I would ask prayer for Betty Dawson, a friend of ours. She is a resident at the Protestant home, and many of you would know Betty. She played the organ and the piano very, very faithfully in the chapel. She is in Pathways. She was in the hospital recently. My understanding is she had a stroke, and I've had trouble trying to connect with her I was able, through one of the nurses at Pathways this week, to talk with Betty on the phone, and I'm going to try to visit her on Tuesday, but wanted to assure her of our prayers. And so I would ask that we be in prayer for Betty. And I asked her if she had a word for us, and she said a big hello. So she sends a big hello to those of us who know and love her. Let us pray for Betty. Yes, Sue. Continued prayers for Ed Engel and Chris Engel. Ed had a fall now, several months ago now, I guess it is, 3 or 4 months ago. I have spoken to Chris sort of back, not long after it started, but have not heard from them recently, but certainly want to keep them in our prayers, Ed Engel and Chris and their family. Let us continue together in prayer. Gracious God, as we have come into this place, as we have made this time important enough to come together, we are thankful for the reminder of the life that we have in you. We realize, O God, that there are not many places where your message of love and goodness are made. And so we thank you for this structure. But more importantly, we thank you for each person who is here within this structure, in this place that we call sanctuary, in this place where we know that your presence is with us, and where we are assured of that presence always. Oh God, we are thankful today to be in the company of one another, so that we might realize anew your mercy and your love for us all, and your call upon our lives, O God, to live out the love that you have shown us, to live out the love that we have learned in the life of your Son, our Savior, Jesus, as he came to show us who you are, as he came to be you among us. Oh God, we thank you for his life, for his teachings, for his example, and for the mercy that is shown to us because of the sacrifice of his life. Oh God, as we continue to worship you, we simply ask that you would be known to us in this time, and assure us, oh God, that you are always with us, so that wherever we are and whatever we are doing, we can know that your spirit is within us and your presence surrounds us and upholds us. Bless us, O God, as we have gathered, as you have heard both our voices aloud and the quiet of our hearts. We thank you that you hear us now and always. We thank you for your faithfulness and love. We trust for now and always, and pray this all together in the name of Jesus, your Son and our Savior, even praying, O God, as he taught us. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses and debts, as we forgive our debtors and those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Mindful of God's faithfulness to us all, let us give thanks through the giving of our tithes and our gifts and our offerings. Let us now receive our morning offering.
For all we have is thine own. is God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above, ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen.
O God, we are thankful. O God, we are grateful to know of all the goodness that you provide for us. We thank you for this time to reflect and to be reminded of your goodness and your faithfulness and your love. Out of thankful hearts, O God, we give these gifts. And we pray that you would bless them so that others who have yet to learn of your goodness will know the bounty of your great love. Bless those who have given and those who will receive. We pray this now through Christ our Lord. Amen. And now let us sing together the hymn Close to Thee.
Thou my everlasting portion, more than friend or life to me, all along my pilgrim journey, Savior, let me walk with Thee. Close to Thee, close to Thee, close to Thee, close to Thee. All along my pilgrim journey, Savior, let me walk with Thee. Not for ease or worldly pleasure, nor for fame my prayer shall be. Gladly will I toil and suffer, only let me walk with Thee. Close to Thee, close to Thee, close to Thee, close to Thee. Gladly will I toil and suffer, only let me walk with Thee. Lead me through the veil of shadows, bear me o'er life's fitful sea. Then the gate of life eternal, may I enter, Lord, with Thee. Close to Thee, close to Thee, close to Thee, close to Thee. Then the gate of life eternal, may I enter, Lord, with Thee.
You may be seated. Now let us hear this lesson from the Gospel of Luke. I stress that to remind us that the scripture itself is a lesson. It is something for us to learn. Hopefully what I have to say in addition to reading this will only affirm it all the more. But the words that we're looking at that matter most are these words today from Luke's gospel. Let us hear now the lesson from Luke's gospel, the 12th chapter, verses 13 through 21. Someone from the crowd said to Jesus, "Teacher, tell my brother to divide the inheritance with me." Jesus said to him, "Man, who appointed me as judge or referee between you and your brother?" Jesus said to them, "Watch out. Guard yourself against all kinds of greed. After all, one's life isn't determined by one's possessions, even when someone is very wealthy." Then he told them a parable. A certain rich man's land produced a bountiful crop. He said to himself, "What will I do? I have no place to store my harvest." Then he thought, "Here's what I'll do. I'll tear down my barns and build bigger ones. That's where I'll store all my grain and goods. I'll say to myself, you have stored up plenty of goods, enough for several years. Take it easy. Eat, drink, and enjoy yourself. But God said to him, fool, tonight you will die. Now, who will get the things you have prepared for yourself? This is the way it will be for those who hoard things for themselves and aren't rich toward God. This is the word of our Lord. Thanks be to God. This lesson is some 2,000 years old. Certainly the idea of sharing does not originate with Jesus. The Old Testament is filled with the idea of sharing and warns against greed. But as apparently it was important enough for Jesus to stress all the more as he does in this passage. Another lesson. These words are but less than 40 years old. Are words from a movie that was put out in 1987. Were you born yet, Joyce, in 1987? All before your life. A movie that came out called Wall Street. Anybody here see Wall Street? A couple? I would imagine those of you who saw it will remember this line. I would also imagine those who didn't see the movie may well recognize this line, because I didn't see the movie and I knew about this line. So it's a line that has kind of transcended the movie itself. Martha, Rich, you'll have to tell everybody what the movie's about. The scene that I want to talk about is simply, I guess, the main character, one of the main characters, Michael Douglas. Is that why you went to see it, Martha? Michael Douglas plays the part of a man named Gordon Gekko. And he's at a stockholders meeting, I think, when he utters these words to those in the who are present with him. He says, greed, for the lack of a better word, is good. Greed is right. Greed works. Greed clarifies, cuts through, and captures the essence of the evolutionary spirit. Greed in all of its forms, greed for life, for money, for love, knowledge, has marked the upward surge of mankind. Now, there were words before that. There were words after that. That's what I wanted us to hear and to counter these words of Jesus as he warns us to guard ourselves against any kind of greed, all kinds of greed. And before I go on, just to show you how prevalent greed is, just this morning, as Farrell and I were walking from the center doors of Frankfurt Memorial there on Dyer Street, many of you have probably gone through those doors. We were walking up toward our car near Oxford Avenue, needing to cross Oakland Street, which is a stop sign. We were approaching the intersection. A car was coming, and all of a sudden I realized he ain't going to stop. And sure enough, the man, I saw a phone. I don't know if that was his only excuse, but he just blew through. And had we continued to walk, we'd be calling on you, doctor, right now. It was an obvious example of greed. His car, where he was going, mattered more than the stop sign that indicated he should stop because there may be foot traffic or other car traffic. There were certainly two people close enough for him to see. But all I can say is, especially in the context of today, he was greedy. He mattered more than us or anyone else. And I dare say I'm glad a car wasn't coming through as well. That could have been a disastrous thing. We have to wonder sometimes if Jesus had this parable ready to go, and it was his intent to speak at this moment. And we wonder that because of how the story is laid out by the gospel writer Luke. Luke simply writes that someone from the crowd said to Jesus, "Teacher, tell my brother to help to divide the inheritance with me." He didn't say it, but it sounds like he was going to say his brother's greedy. His brother wants to keep it all to himself. Jesus, help us to separate this out, to figure this out. And Jesus wisely says, "Uh-uh, man. You work that out with your brother." And how many of us know that story or know others who know that story, of families that fight over items in their households, often simply because of greed, of wanting things for oneself. And it was upon that confrontation that Jesus then turns to the crowd and says, "Watch out, everybody. Watch out. Guard yourself against all kinds of greed. After all, one's life isn't determined by one's possessions, even when someone is very wealthy." In other words, wealth is not a sign of godliness. Wealth is not a sign of godliness. And those who are wealthy would do well to hear these words of warning by Jesus. And so he tells the parable of the rich man who has this bountiful crop, so much so that he doesn't have anywhere to put it. And only thinking of himself, he realizes that the solution is to tear down his barns and build bigger ones so that all of these crops can be his and can remain to be his. And so, as he says this, he realizes he can take it easy. He can eat and drink, enjoy himself, until God and then came and knocked on his door. And Martha, you know the end of the story, don't you? Martha just chuckled, but she knows the end of the story. Someone at Frankfurt Memorial, even before I said anything, I was simply reading the gospel lesson. When I got to this point, I heard a from one of the members of the church there. We know this story and how it ends. God knocked on the door and said, "Tonight you will die. Tonight you will die." And now, who gets all of these things that you have only prepared for yourself? This man in Jesus' story never looks beyond the perimeter of his property. He never thinks of sharing any bit of grain with anyone else but himself. And so when he learns that he is about to die, imagine the thought. Jesus doesn't tell us, and maybe he doesn't need to tell us, because our chuckles, our we know what that will feel like for such a man. I don't want to be morbid, but I want to remind us all that we will all have one of those nights. We will all have an end of our lives. I've been reminded of that too well. And I will always remember the few years that I had knowing that there was an aneurysm inside of me, an aneurysm that would be replaced or would be repaired, I was promised, but I had to live with it for a while. And all of you and many others so often, are you doing okay? Are you doing okay? And if you remember, my pat answer came to be, I'm okay now, just ask me the day before. And there were so many times that I must have said that I will never forget the day before in October of 2007. And I realized I'm okay. I'm in God's hands. I'm in God's arms. And whatever happens to me is okay because of that. And the truth is that we are all in those hands of God. Even this man who Jesus tells the story of. The difference is this man didn't know there were others to his left and to his right. God's arms are big and huge and can hold us all. This man thought God was only holding him. He was the one who was blessed, and he didn't have to share any of that blessing with anyone. It's why Jesus warns us, because the life that is ours is ours. It is not mine. It is not yours alone. It is our life. And Jesus taught that idea of ours over and over and over again. Here, in those just very simple words to understand, watch out, guard yourself against all kinds of greed. The world tells us that greed is good. We hear that over and over and over again. Maybe not in the graphic words that greed is good, but we hear it in our advertisements, in our lifestyles. We hear it through others of how you only need to care for yourself. Here and in places like this, we want to hear what God has to say. And what God has to say to us this morning is watch out. Watch out. Guard yourselves against the greed that is easily fallen into. So today, as we think about this, as we measure our own lives against God's generosity, may we realize anew that we are all in the arms of God and that we share this life together. And may we have the boldness and the faith to lift our eyes beyond our own perimeters of our own properties and places and possessions and realize the option that this man didn't see, and that is to share. To share what was his with others. He didn't see it. He was blind to it. Hopefully, we won't be. Amen. Desirous to live godly lives and godly living, let us stand together and affirm our faith in God, through these words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. And now let us prayerfully sing together, "Take My Life and Let It Be." And serve God and your neighbor in all that you do. And know this day that the blessing of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit goes with you now and will remain with you forevermore. Amen.
Earthly joy I craved, sought peace and rest. Now thee alone I seek, give what is best. This all my prayer shall be, more love, O Christ, to thee, more love to thee, more love to thee. To thee, more love to thee.
God bless you all. Go in peace.